Mark Sheppard!
So, how many of you are new here? Yeah. Right, expect to see all of you in the gig tonight, otherwise I'm not talking to you tomorrow. Seriously. So, you're all brand new, right? Pretty much half of you. You're brand new, that's good. So personal, isn't it? So, welcome, it's good. Hey, yeah, nice to see you. So, shut up, you. I'm talking. The grown-ups are talking now, you can wait. So, hi. You having fun? You guys having fun? Hanging out with the poor people in the back, I like that. Hey. Hey, you, good shirt. Nice tasty shirts. Hey, you right? You nervous? I can make you really nervous.
Both my children call me from different places, like,
oh my God, what does this mean? the world is a very dodgy and frightening place. It's a very big place, and we seem to be connected to all of it. When I was a kid, to get information about the rest of the world, it was a lot more difficult to do. It was a lot scarier. No, actually it wasn't. It was a lot less scary when I was a kid, because you've now been bombarded with whatever sells. News sells. You have to sell the commercials in between the news programs. Right? So you're being bombarded by word stories for the next. So we constantly talk about the fact that Kim Jong-il or Kim Jong-un or Kim Jong-anybody or mentally ill, whatever his name is, is always being able to construct a rocket that will or will not reach my backyard. So far they haven't made it get past the sea of Japan, so it's kind of interesting. You know, can't get out of their backyard. But this is a thing that tormented my now 17-year-old since he was 6 years old. And the idea, because it's something to report, it's something to say. And it's like, they did this, they fired this. It, you know, we used to have ex-kids with the Russians. The Russians are coming, you know. My dad's generation before that, you know, was post, you know, World War II, and what was coming after that, the bad guys were very identifiable. And so now it's everywhere. They're all coming together, so they all want to. You know, it sells news to say it's not safe to walk down the street. It sells news to say, you know, that the world's going to have a handbag soon. It kind of is. But it also kind of isn't, because I have faith in people. I really do have faith in people. I think people are the honest. So, I think the worst thing that you can be as a youth or as an adult is alone, with the feeling that you're alone. I think it's the worst feeling in the world. And in such a gigantic place, there's so many nasty and uncomfortable things going on. I think it makes it scary when you're on your own. So I think things like this are the great social experiment. I'm sober 27 years, coming up 27. Yeah, sorry. You wouldn't like to see me drunk, just it would be. I have better things to do when I'm drinking. But the truth of the matter is that's a great social experiment too. AA for me has a bonding effect, so I didn't feel I was on my own. And for that, to be able to come together with other groups of like-minded people to try to solve a common problem is a massive big deal. We don't have that as a social entity. It's a kind of frowned upon. People look at those sort of entities as there's usually something wrong with them or something suspicious about coming together to do something. And I find that when I come to places like this, and I abuse you guys the way I did, without being too heavy about it, the fact is that, you know, 50% of this room is new. The other 50% has come more than once, right? I would say so. And based on that, the 50% that have been here before know that there is a camaraderie here, that there are friends here, and there's connections that are made, that we do this, and we can see this. And this is the human connection, which you can't do down through a television screen or via the internet. Not really the same way. The fact that we're here and able to do this. So you've got to, first of all, we've got to look at the fact that creation creates a venue by which we can do this, which is very different than doing a signing page. And this becomes, in a strange way, in a rather wonderful way, kind of like a lifestyle choice. It becomes more of a group of people coming together, enjoying their company as much as they enjoy through the shop, but enjoying the company and the things we do. What I'm so proud of is the fact that you guys take our causes and ideas, sometimes your causes and ideas, and they meld together and become a powerful force actually trying to change things across your world. I mean, maybe not changing government, maybe not changing massive things that way, but every time you guys contribute to anything that we've established or tried to establish, you make a difference. I mean, I know I've got Camp Comrade Chile, which is a stay-away camp for kids with diabetes, kids and teens with diabetes, type 1 diabetes. You know, they are receiving checks regularly. You guys have for me. they're like, this makes a huge difference. We had a supernatural friend, a wonderful supernatural friend, who literally bought their wish list 2 years ago. Literally went away and went, oh, there's a wish list. Fine, let's buy all that and ship it. And pay to ship it. Wow. So you're going like, it made a massive difference. And it really did. And it's not, for some, you know, little patch you're slapping on the side or something. It changed that year's ability to have parents let their kids leave their damn house for a period of time and not have to wake up four times a night to make sure that their kids are alive. Knowing that they're at a camp without cell phones, with doctors, nurses, and other diabetics, and that they're being taken care of. And parents go on a 2-week vacation while kids are climbing trees and cutting crap, building stuff, and, you know, tormenting each other and having the fun that kids are supposed to have. Getting to feel normal and part of. But together, you guys make that possible. That's what it is. That's what we do. Then we move on to the, you know, the other one. I'm going to get this out of the way so we don't get to the end of the end of this. You know, we're dealing right now in this world with a lot of mental health issues. A lot of mental health issues. It's just it's the nature of the times. It could be the nature of you like walking too much chance to see your parents here. I had no idea. But the truth of it is some way or another, either the world is so much harsher and our abilities to deal with it are not as good. But I don't think in the last 20 years that the world has been able to absorb how much depression and how much difficulty there actually is. And it's either been the silent killer or the silent, you know, the silent disease that nobody talks about. Or maybe it is, there is more of it than there ever was before. Maybe that socially we're creating anxiety and depression on a level that we've never done before. Either way, coming together as groups of people is a lot more fun than sitting at home contemplating killing yourself. I mean, it really is, if you can get out of the house. I mean, so not to trivialize suicide, not to trivialize depression. But being able to be with other people, not be alone in a feeling, is a massive difference. It is a massive difference. And so I'm so proud of my fellow actors and my friends who are trying to do so much to change the way the world looks at these issues. You know, by admitting that they have them, first of all, which is an incredible thing. And then pretty much everybody here admitting that if you don't have it, you certainly know somebody who does. You know, so it's no longer the stigma that it was. So people can get help. Talk about it, so it no longer becomes the hidden crack that it's been for so many years. Let alone the other stuff that we have to deal with, you know, actual physical, literal physical problems that require, you know, huge effort and difficulty to do. It seems to me this is the catalyst for a lot of people coming together to do very positive things, is what I'm ultimately trying to say. Doesn't mean you have to have mental illness to be a supernatural fan, although it does happen. I mean, I can't say that liking Castiel or Misha is not a mental illness in and of itself. That hasn't been proved, and I am not a mental health expert. But I think there's something really wrong dressing up as John Constantine pretending to be. It's just something really sad. I don't know. That was just me. Maybe that's my mental health issues that are bringing me to that. But I love what you guys do. As much as this is a precious thing for me. I can't get this through a television screen. You know, I know you a very long time. Right? I know you a very long time. I love you. Just checking. I've known a lot of you a very long time. And it has meaning to me. It does have meaning to me, and I appreciate your support. But we are actually doing stuff. I really believe that we are trying to do stuff. We're not just taking. I love the fact that it's giving. And I'm really proud of you guys for doing it. And I've got to tell you, you've got to give creation props. You know, yeah, it's a business. That's the function of the business. You have to put money into it to make it work. The logistics are huge, if you think about what the logistics are. To move this around the country. It's insane. But, you know, they do it with a style and a flair, a creation, that means that we get more of this than we do almost any of us. Right? So yeah. Give creation a big impact. So, that's enough of the really exciting, fun stuff. Now let's get really dark and depressing. It's a wonderful thing. I love doing this. Want to know why I come here? This is why. I come here to do this, but I come here to play music on Sunday nights. It's fun. That's what it's about. That's the joy. That's the share the love. It's all about sharing love. So to answer your question, anything that is an expression of love or unity or caring or involvement is how you get through anything. You can't change the way you feel by thinking. You can only change the way you feel by doing. So you have to do something. So participate, join in, you don't feel strong enough, put your hand out, go, I don't feel strong enough. Somebody will come and help you. Come here. Make sure you talk about it. Nothing stays here. Nothing should ever be here when feelings are that big or that ugly. Talk about it. Ask for help. Get help. You are great people. You kind of like somebody here. I wasn't blaming you. And I wasn't doing it. I have a friend who has a problem. But I'm saying, just in general, it applies to the soul. It applies to the soul. You know, you is also, in English, also means inclusive of one, us. So, join you. If you need help, put your hand up. That's what you do. There's no excuse for it. You don't do this on your own. It's not okay to go off into the corner and hate yourself. It's just not cool. If somebody's hating on you, that's their tough luck. You know what I'm saying? That's their tough luck. Come here and have some fun. Who's next?
Hi.
Sometimes my aim is good. Sometimes my aim is very good. Season 7?
Yeah.
For me?
Yeah.
Why?
I don't know.
Because I got to say dick every 3 minutes. Dick. Hi. I'm still here. You gonna use curse words? Yeah, it's good. Yeah, they know.
Thank you. In front?
Yes.
She first convention?
No.
This is not what you expected.
No.
Better or worse?
Better.
How old are you?
I'm 15.
15. It's a good thing. So welcome. We'll try not to scare you too much.
Thank you.
Did I ask you a question?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. I meant to. Thank you.